Step, mother had a surprise for us. Meanwhile, the witch, for purposes of her own, explains how the couple might lift this boat.
You wish to have the curse reversed? I'll need a special potion. First, go to the wood and bring me back one cow, white as milk. Two, the king as red as blood. Three,
sir. Now, I'm resting.
How much are you asking for the animal?
No less than 5 pounds.
Oh, now, Jack, why such a sum?
My mother told me.
Your mother? A boy your age? Why, you'd be lucky to exchange her for a second.
Well, I... Oh, come along, Milky White. There are spirits here.
Find that red cape, nor a golden cow or a yellow slipper. Or was it a golden slipper and a yellow cow?
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the slipper is pure as gold.
What are you doing here?
You forgot your scarf.
You've no business being alone in the wood. And you've no idea what I've come upon here. Would be frightened for your life.
Help.
No, the spell is on my house. to give £5.
She must be generous of milk to fetch £5.
Oh, yes, ma'am.
And if you can't fetch that sum, then what are you going to do?
Oh, I haven't thought of that. I suppose Mother and I will have no food to eat.
This is the sum total.
Beans! We mustn't give up our beans! Well, if you feel we must, beans will bring you food, son.
Beans in exchange for my cow?
Oh, these are no ordinary beans, son. These beans carry magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell him.
Magic that defies description.
My mother would definitely not like it if I was...
You
would be lucky to exchange her for a second.
How many beans?
Six.
Five. We can't part with all of them. We must leave one for ourselves. Besides, I'd say they're worth a pound each at the very least.
Could I buy her back someday?
Well, possibly. Up there, young man.
I was trying to be helpful.
Magic beans? We've no reason to believe their magic. Are we going to dispel this curse through deceit?
No one would have given him more for that creature. We did him a favor. At least they'll have some food.
Five beans?
If you know what you want, then you go and you find it and you get it.
Oh.
Do we want a child or not? And you give and you take and you bid and you bargain or you live to regret it.
Will you please go home?
There are rights and wrongs. One waits when fortune intervenes, and maybe they're really magic. Who knows? Oh, I do what you do, that's the point. All the rest of it is chatter.
Look at her, she's crying.
Everything you do is pure intent. If it's meant and it's just a little bent, does it matter?
Yes.
No one matters if everyone tells tiny lies. What's important really is the size. Only three more tries, and we'll have our prize when the end's in sight.
Oh.
get it?
My granny made it for me.
Is that right? I'd love a red cloak like that. May I take a look at it?
I don't like to be without my cape. Please give it back.
Oh, I want it badly.
Give it back, please. Now get the little girl and get the cape.
Thank you. like none that you've ever known. The sky is lead and the earth is stone. You're free to do whatever pleases you. Exploring things you've never dared, cause you don't care. And suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at your door. A big, tall, terrible lady giant sweeping the floor. And she gives you food and she gives you rest as she draws him close to her giant breast. And you know things now that you never knew before. Not till the sky.
Oh, just me, made a friend and all anew. She's big, but no, this small, still bigger than her. Who's along the hall to swallow you for lunch. And your heart is lead and your stomach's stone. And it really scared me all the then that you aren't the things you are in the world you left. But you know the fun is done. You steal what you can and run. And a scrabble down the hole you go. And the world you know begins to run.
The house and your mother at the door. The room, the house and the world you never thought to explore. And you think of all of the things you see. And you wish that you could live in between, and you're back again, only different than before.
After the sky, there are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky.
Buy baking supplies for a year. I could buy a new thatched roof and a new chimney.
But could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem delirious. But when explained, I am nothing serious. Would you buy yourself a child?
I don't understand.
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces? 10? 20?
I've not thought to put a price on it. That back. It's not yours.
Nor is it Jack's. The money is not what's important. It's what is important is that you wish the honor.
Wait. Come back here.
This. Don't give me that, you fool! I don't want to touch that! How
the woods?
Yes, at the top of the tall tower.
It has no door, Stan.
Where?
2 weeks from here.
2 weeks, just beyond Mossy Knoll.
And how do you manage your visit?
I stand beneath her tower, and I say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let down your hair to me. And then she lowers the longest, most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel, what kind of name is that? You jest. I have never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth.
She is as true as your maiden. A maiden running from a prince. None would run from us.
Yet one has.
Did I abuse her or show her disdain? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech, when the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach. High in the tower she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair, blithely humming, frequently humming a light-hearted air. Ah, agony, far more painful than yours. When you know she would go with you if there only were doors. Agony, for the
one entire day left. Surely we can locate the slipper by then.
We don't allow him to stay.
Well, perhaps it will take the two of us to get this child.
Just 2 days ago, you were accusing me of exercising sacrificing the seat and securing the cow.
Then don't steal it and resign yourself to a childless life.
I feel it's best you go for the cows. I have met a maiden with a golden slipper these previous years, and I think I might succeed in obtaining one of her shoes.
Fine. Fine. That is simply fine.
Tunes without your even having to touch it.
Of course it does. Why are
prefer a live cow.
Of course I prefer a live cow! So bring me the dead cow, and I'll bring it back to life!
You could do that?
No!
Careful. Charles' bride, and ask the other sister to try on the shoe.
Son.
And much to the dismay of the stepmother and her daughters, Prince took Cinderella.
reach the right conclusions.
And because that's we deserve.
Oh,
went all from your son.
I'm sorry, but you will get none from us. No one cares there's a giant in my backyard. I don't remember you volunteering to come to my aid.
A giant in your backyard is one thing. A destroyed house is quite another.
Look, young man, giants never strike the same house twice. I would worry.
I'm taking the news to the castle nonetheless.
When the baker reached the castle, it was the princess who greeted the news. The story unfolds.
Excuse me, madam. This small man insists on seeing you.
Princess, I've come to report the appearance of a giant in the land.
Well, where did you see a giant?
Well, I didn't exactly see it.
Well, then how do you know there's a giant in the land?
Our house was destroyed, and there are footprints.
That could have been caused by any number of things. I'll show you to the door.
Wait!
A nearby household was visited by a giant not too long ago, descending from a beanstalk.
Yes. Oh, I remember.
That giant was slain. Now come along.
Wait, please. We have a young child. Princess, our child was very difficult to come by. His safety is of great importance to me.
Are we entirely through now?
Yes.
I will take these things up.
Frightening the young thing.
You can't frighten her.
Well, I guess we're able to happen to
My Rapunzel has run off. Run off? She's a changed woman. She has been subject to hysterical fits of crying. Moods that no soul can forgive. I know not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
She remains well.
Does she now, brother? Do tell what you're really doing.
High in a tablet like yours was the higher beauty of sleep. Or of the tower would make it a briar 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration or heat. When the one thing you want is a thing that you've not even seen.
I have a casket inside the other glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside your basket, made in a mess. Just as unbreakable.
What unmistakable agony.
The giant! Where is the lad who killed my husband?
There's no lad here.
We haven't seen him.
I want the lad who climbed the beanstalk.
We'll get him for you right away. Don't move. It was you who killed my brother. Mad Red Wind, it's because of you I'm no mother.
And who destroyed my house? That boy asked for shelter. And then he stole our gold, our hen, and our harp. Then he killed my husband. I must avenge the wrongdoings.
We are not responsible for him.
You're wasting your breath.
She's right. You can't reason with a dumb giant.
Not all giants are dumb. Give me the boy.
We told him he's not here.
The girl is telling the truth.
I know he's there, and I'm going to wait right here until he's delivered to me.
The giant, who was nearsighted, remained convinced that she had found the lad. There was no consensus among the group as to which course of action to take.
Put a spell on her! I no longer have my powers. If I did, do you think I'd be standing around here with all of you? Now, we have to give her someone.
I'm waiting.
You must understand, these were not the people familiar with making choices. The prior experience in the woods had in no way prepared them to deal with the force this brings.
Would you like a blind girl instead? How dare you? What's the matter with their misery?
You're not that miserable!
What are you talking about?
She doesn't cause a woman.
Fine! Then what do you suggest we do?
I'm still waiting.
It is interesting to examine the moral issue question. An honor score such as these dictates that... No, no, sorry. I tell the story, I'm not part of it.
Not one of us.
You're always on the outside.
That's my role. You must understand there must always be someone on the outside.
You're going to be on the inside now.
Now I must punish him for his wrongs.
We suffered too. Do you think it was a picnic disposing of your husband's remains?
You are getting me angry. Where is your... Is that him?
No, no, this is not the boy. See there?
The boy is hiding in the secret tower.
Yes.
That's true.
Yes.
If he is not, I will return and find you.
Oh.
return here.
The giants will not harm them. I know.
How do you know?
I know.
But what if?
But what if? But what if? Will only a giant's foot stop your arguing? 100 paces, go!
The royal family. The castle's been set upon by the giant.
Oh, and the prince?
He was not with him. You must come with me. You shall be safe in Alcove.